which everybody does, like a robo or cyborg, if a person imitates just for his payment, prosperity, development, transfer and promotions, which are all the visible benefits of knowledge and limited benefits of knowledge, anybody can do it with their master degrees or some doctorates. But ontology is meant for jnana pipasus, the persons who are willing to govern the world. There are two things. If you want self-maintenance, you can read the faculty. If you want global governance and maintenance, you have to deal with ontology. That if you want to cook for you, a small vessel is enough. If you want to organize a marriage festival, then the area required, the materials required, the vessel sizes, the ingredients included, everything will be more. It depends upon whom you are going to apply. It cannot be, we cannot bring all people to the same platform. That is the wonderful blunder of modern education system, which has resulted in successful failure. The thing is, how can you group the person's ability? How can you group person's career position? How can you group a person's intelligence and intention? How can you group? Like a sheep, there is a flock of sheep which will be driven by that is shepherds. They will have the same work. They will have a monotonous pattern of moving and grazing and coming back. Either it's grazing or repatriation and self-flocking systems, they are all trained and tamed. And now we are put into such a flock which Jesus himself cannot make shepherdship in a very successful manner. Because, number one, a person's career molding, a person's intelligence and ability design, and three, track analysis and proper channelization. These three things are very essential at the level of their 8th, 10th and 12th standard respectively, which is not being done by any person at all. So, ontology is required only for people, those who want to contribute something to the pride of our nation. I have already told in that scientist conference, scientists are very much invisible in proportion. That too young scientists, that too Indian scientists, that too Indian young scientists. So if you want to bring pride, when I attended the seminar for concrete, nano concrete and nano cement, it is the process is going on in South Deakin University, international scholars they came. I told that it is a process up to 2011. We must build such a team which must tirelessly work for achieving it in 2009 or 10, being a pioneer of that concrete industry, that is leadership in the world. Likewise, anybody who wants to achieve. So I must certainly design everything, a product, what are all the synergy, energy and allergy factors, a real person, a real marketing person, his position is to not only describe the greatness, but also to reveal the weakness of the persons, whether it is affordable, accessible and productive to the person or not. So as a person to market this divine intelligence or the process of applied or collective consciousness, it is my duty describe for whom it is applicable and what must be the motto of life of persons, the purpose of life. I have already told teleology. What must be the purpose of life of the person who wants to come inside it? What is the connection between a weaver and a monkey? The monkey will totally spoil the weaver's process. Likewise, it may be non-related, it may be totally adverse, it may be beyond the reach, but if there is desire, if there is desire and if there is passion, divinity and destiny, it can be brought into control. Four D's are there. Desire and dedication, if the first two D's are offered, then the other two D's we can bring into existence. So let me start with the mind. You know that when the human beings were realizing about themselves and others, they first understood only about the surroundings. They were very much interested in understanding about the surroundings. Even now, human being, even if they commit some mistakes and if somebody quarrels with them, they will more concern about the person's quarrelsome nature and report about that without concerning their own mistake. It is a natural phenomenon. So, Pashyati Pareshu Doshan Ityuktam Subhashita Nivi Granthe. Like that, it is the nature of human being. What is the nature of human being? It is known as the observational instinct. It is not the self-introspective or analytical instinct. It is, there is two analytical instinct systems. One is endo-analytical, second is exo-analytical. This endo-analytical system that deals with a person's deserving nature, what are all the steps to be taken and how to work hard, these are the endo-analytical procedures. Exo-analytical, he is doing that, I am also going to do that. Whether we deserve or not, whether the competition is viable or not, these things are not taken. Because it is the inherent blunder. There are 27 inherent blunders of human consciousness and behavior. Those things have to be eradicated by of self-taming or taming by elite, enlightened or ephemeral personalities. such personality they have to, it is known as, first thing known as confluential erection, second thing is known as influential correction. If it is done by the inner self or it is made by any external force acting on us, that is how it is made. Likewise, the human being's instinct just started with knowing about the surroundings and patterning the surroundings as per their taste, desire and necessity. Samjnanam prajnanam vijnanam. The knowledge about the self is known as samjnana. The knowledge about the surroundings made by the self is known as vijnana. The knowledge about the self on super self is known as prajnana. These are all the basic classifications made by the Vedic scriptures. Number one, just to start with, it was believed in earlier days in the systems of study, either in science or in philosophy, that mind is nothing but the function of brain. There is nothing known as mind, because we could see physically or in a gross procedure or process, we could not see any structure as mind and its functions. They consider that there is no mind at all, and mind is nothing but the image of brain. It was there in the primary philosophy. Even the great philosophers of the West, like Bertrand Russell, he told there is nothing known as consciousness. It is a specially arranged structure of the matter itself. And Charvaka, they told that Panchabhuti Chaitanyasya Janani iti. When these five elements are mixed, just as the betel leaves, the small calcium sediment along with the betel nuts, they are mixed. Some new red color which is not there already, it is a sandhi guna. It is a contribution of their unison. Like that, if materials are automatically mixed in a cosmic procedure, it creates consciousness. There is nothing known as consciousness. Consciousness is a specially arranged group of material molecules. That was the statement of Bertrand Russell. Likewise, the Charvaka philosophy, Bauddha philosophy, Jaina philosophy, then in Bauddha also, Vaibhashika, Sautrantika, Yogacara, Madhyamika philosophies, the Nayayika's contribution of consciousness, Pashupata, Sankhya contribution, the Yoga contribution, and that tenets of consciousness that exist in Vishishta Advaita, 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 Bhava Advaita, Shuddha Advaita, Achintya Veda, Veda, these things are subjected to philosophical discussions. Now, let me start with the study of mind, and then the brain, and then the consciousness. At first they told that there is nothing known as mind, and now they understood that brain was not absolutely independent for its functions. There are two types of actions. One is known as the inner life, second is known as the outer life. What we have as feelings, instincts, sensations and emotions. We do have appetite, we do have thirst, and other things are the biological instincts. So these things, biophysical, biochemical, chemobiological, chemophysiological, biophysiological, biochemical, neurophysical, neurobiological, neurochemical, neuropsychiatric. All of these things are now read, and everybody is training their brains now in the pursuit of what is happening, and they are very much confused about what is going to happen to them. Least bothering about the brain. So these sciences now, it proves that apart from the brain has areas. The areas that are classified by the Vedic Siddhanta as the areas of Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. If it is olfactory, then it deals with the olfactory determination, acceptance, repulsion, olfactory identification, classification, elucidation, all of the things are in the olfactory sense. In the taste buds, likewise, determination, analytical study, permission, repulsion, all of these instincts are there, basic instincts are there. Then in the classification, these things are with lot of variations, inferential classification, cognitive classification with Esther memories, innovative classification of one's own standard of perception. Lot of these things are there, it requires a note to write all of these things. So we have this basic tanmatras, are behaviors of our five gross elements or organs and their functions, and the basis of which our physical activities, karmendriya and gyanendriya, they are bifurcated into two. And these karmendriyas, they just govern the biological functions, and gyanendriya, they deal with the biomechanical and biointellectual or biocognitive or neurocognitive functions. They have read that there are positions like carpus callosum, centromedial nucleus, these are all the major positions, like Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, these are all the major positions, like hyperthalamus. These positions, they have understood that it is the aesthetic area.